Hollywood is not the biggest film industry in the world, it's our Indian film industry. India makes thrice as many movies as the US does, the biggest film studio in the world is in India, and the richest actor in the world is an Indian. And the person who gave India the magic of cinema, Dadasaheb Phalke, is a reason to love India. Today, 30th April is his birthday, and I just want to say thank you, because I love Indian movies. But how was film born in India? Today, in the next 3 minutes, I want to tell you the story of Dadasaheb Phalke, the father of Indian cinema. Unki life bhi ek film se kam nahi thi. He was born on 30th April in 1870 in Maharashtra. Drawing, printing, photography. He took odd jobs in different fields.
He was working as a photographer in Gujarat, lekin wo business chal nahi paya because people thought that the camera sucks the soul out of a person.
He was still interested in the magic of photography. One day, he saw a new trick. Moving images. Movies. He saw a movie named The Life of Christ and it changed his life. He said, hey, can we tell our stories, the stories from Ramayana, Mahabharata and our Purans in this format? Dadasaheb was inspired by the idea of Swadeshi, the idea that we can create something good in India and movies can unite all of Indians.
He had a strange idea that making films would be a profitable business.
Everybody laughed. Something that seems obvious today was laughable just 100 years ago.
And for this idea, he sold off most of his property, sold off his wife's jewelry, took a massive loan of 30,000 rupees and went to London to get a film camera. And that's how his journey started, to make the first film of India.
His family, his house, was the first production house of India. He was the director, producer, cameraman and even actor in his movies. His wife Saraswati managed costumes and his children acted in his films.
On 3rd May 1913, he finished making India's first film, Raja Harishchandra.
The story of how he made it is explained beautifully in the Marathi movie Harishchandrachi Factory. But today I want to tell you what happened after the movie. Us samay zyada theaters nahi the, but the few people who watched this movie wanted to see more of it. Dadasaheb became a magician overnight. But there was one problem. Money. India was still under British occupation. We fought two world wars for them. And nobody had the money to spend on an expensive art of filmmaking.
When he was in London to study more about films, Warner Brothers wanted to buy 200 copies of his film. Lekin wo deal fix nahi ho paayi because he had to come back to India.
His studio caught fire, he went bankrupt, and he even lost his eyesight for a short while. But all of this didn't kill his passion for the magic he saw on screen. In just 19 years, he produced 95 films and 26 short films. And even after all of this, India mein jaise hi movies thodi popular hone lagi, jaise hi is industry mein thoda bahut paisa aane laga, India Dadasaheb ko bhool gaya. The father of Indian cinema, the person who started an industry which is worth $2 billion today, died a broke man. In his last days, V. Shantaram, the legendary filmmaker, gave him an award of 5,000 rupees for his contribution to Indian cinema. And Dadasaheb wanted to spend even that money in making films.
Even after his death, it took the government 25 years to declare an award in his name.
Lekin sawal ye hai ki ek award announce karne se kya farak padta hai? Aaj bhi Dadasaheb Phalke ji ko Bharat Ratna nahi mila. Unke hi naam par jo award dete hain, unme unhi ki family ko nahi bulate. Aur Bollywood, ek industry jo abhi bhi unke karze mein hai, unke life par ek dhang ki film nahi bana payi.
There's a Marathi film, Harishchandrachi Factory. But don't you think his contribution deserves a mainstream Hindi film?
We have so many great stories, lekin fir bhi hamare Hindi cinema mein story hoti hi kahan hai? Aur hamara problem wahi hai. Hum masala filmein banayenge aur stories, logic aur human struggle ko aise uthakar side mein rakh denge. Bhool jayenge, ignore kar denge, lekin badal nahi payenge. Dadasaheb's story started with a magic called technology. And another magic called the internet has given me the power to tell this story to you. Ab power aapke haath mein. कोई कपूर चोपड़ा या जौहर डिसाइड नहीं करेगा कि आपको क्या देखना चाहिए. You will decide.
So choose the stories that you would like to see more. Encourage them, empower them and support them.
Share this video if you feel Dadasaheb's contribution should reach the next generation. What Dadasaheb's story teaches us is that हर कोई एडिसन नहीं बन पाता. लेकिन सिर्फ एडिसन बनने की गारंटी नहीं है, इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि एक्सपेरिमेंट करना छोड़ दें. When we believe in our ideas, when we are ready to fight for them till our last breath, we create something that exceeds our lifetime. We create a legacy. And whether people give you credit for it or not, you know that creating an industry out of a joke is the job of a magician. And what we see on screen is nothing short of magic.